Well, good evening, Sumter School District boys and girls, and welcome to another evening of Reading with the Superintendent. As promised, we've extended our evenings of reading beyond the last day of school because, one, we have so much fun reading with you, and two, I have a list of some special guests who will be joining me. I'd like to take the opportunity just to introduce our very special guests for tonight. Dr. David Laws. Oh, good evening, Dr. Laws. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thank you for having me. Very excited to be.
Thank you for joining us. Why don't you take the opportunity to introduce yourself to our guests?
Yes, ma'am. I am Dr. David Laws, Jr. I am the Director of Career and Technical Education for Sumter School District and Instructional Technology. I'm very excited to have this opportunity to read to our great audience.
Well, we're excited, one, to read because reading is fun, and I just need to make sure that we're engaging our learners while school is out. So before we begin reading, I just need to make sure I have everyone's attention. So one, two, three, all eyes on me.
One, two, all eyes on you.
So Dr. Laws, why don't you tell our audience what we'll be reading, and we'll begin this process of having fun.
Thank you. Today we're going to be reading Library Mouse by Daniel Kirk.
Library Mouse, huh?
Yes. Library Mouse.
This should be interesting. There's just something about reading about mice. Just something about mice, period.
About mice. They look so cute, at least on the picture they do.
They're cute. They're cute. In the book.
So let's see. Library Mouse by Daniel Kirk. Sam was a library mouse. His home was in a little hole in the wall behind the children's reference book. And he thought that life was very good indeed. Every day, when the library was full of people walking up and down the aisles, studying, checking out books, and working on the computers, Sam was curled up in a little hole, sound asleep. Every night, when the people went home and the room was dark and quiet, the library belonged to Sam.
Laws, put some speed behind that book. Come on, come on, come on. It's a little windy outside. It should go faster than this. And every night, Sam read, and he read, and he read. Sam read picture books and chapter books. He read biographies and poetry, cookbooks and sport books, fairy tales and ghost stories and mysteries by the dozen. Wow, he's really engaging his mind. Do you read at night, Dr. Laws?
Yes, I do.
You do? What kind of books do you like to read?
Well, it depends. Situation. A lot of time as a pastor, I'm reading scripture references.
Oh, okay. I love reading at night.
Sam's mind was filled with facts and information and images of faraway places, and his imagination brimmed over with wonder and fantasy. One night, Sam decided that it was time he wrote a book of his own.
Wow. Curveball. Sam folded over some little squares of paper he took from the librarian's desk to make the pages. Then he found a pencil that had rolled underneath the shelf, and he began to write. Write what you know. Sam had read a book about writing, so Sam wrote about being a mouse. He drew the pictures for his book by posing in his little mirror and then sketching what he saw. He wrote about himself. I know that in art they do this a lot. They look in the mirror and they draw portraits. I never thought about it for writing a book. And Sam is cute. You ever write a book, Dr. Laws?
I was just thinking, you know, that would be a great thing to do, is to do what Sam has done, and that is to write about things that we know, write about our experiences. That would be something new.
I think you already wrote a book, though. That's how you got doctor in the front of your name, right?
Definitely a book.
But that's another conversation.
Yes, yes, yes. A lot of times we write and we don't know that it could be codified. Mm-hmm. Sam worked very, very hard. And finally, his first book was done. He called it Squeak, A Mouse Life. So fitting. And he wrote on the cover, words and pictures by Sam. He went to the biography and autobiography section of the library, and he tucked in his first book onto the chair. Then he went back to his little hole in the wall and waited.
I wonder what he's waiting for. That's the book, Squeak. Squeak. The next afternoon, sunlight streamed in through the library windows. What's this? Asked a girl whose teacher had sent her. Let me restate that statement. What's this? Asked a girl whose teacher had sent her to the library to do a book report. I've never seen anything like this before, said the librarian. And she put Squeak, A Mouse's Life, on her desk. Later, she showed it to the other librarians. Wow, this book is a hit, huh? Squeak. I guess it comes from all that time spending in the library and at night. What did you say when you read those pages? Spending all of his time in the library? It was all to himself.
Sam decided to write another book. It was called The Lonely Cheese. And working on the book made him feel very hungry. It was a good thing that he always found so many crumbs to eat by the trash basket in the hallway. When he had finished the illustrations, Sam scurried to the picture book section and proudly placed his latest book on the shelf. Then he went back to his little hole in the wall and waited.
I read a book about cheese.
Who moved my cheese?
Who moved my cheese? I think we all had to read that book. The next morning, sunlight streamed in through the library windows. What's this? Asked the little boy who was looking for a big book about trucks. It's another book by Sam, said the librarian. Just who is this Sam? She thought to herself, put the lonely cheese on her desk. Later, she showed it to the children at story time. She wants to know who this Sam character is. Sam's making a big hit. The Lonely Cheese. Move My Cheese. So that means you read the book also, The Iceberg is Melting, right? Did you read that one? Have you read that one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Maybe you need to sleep with Sam sometimes and get some library books.
Yes, ma'am. Sam decided to write a chapter book while going bigger. It is called The Mystery of Mouse Mansion. And it gave Sam goosebumps when he wrote down the scary parts. The full moon was shining down through the windows of the darkened library where Sam crept over into the mystery section and sneakily placed his book on the shelf. Then he went back to his little hole in the wall and waited.
I don't know a book about mountains, but I know music about a mountain. It's called Night on Bald Mountain. Do you know that song? You know that song? Night on Bald Mountain. Very nice. Very mysterious. Similar to this. The next day, sunlight streamed through the library windows. What's this? Asked a teenager who was looking for a book that was creepy to read before bed. Mm-hmm. We've got to find out who this Sam is, said the librarian. I'll leave a note on the bulletin board and tell him that I would like to meet our new author. She put the mystery of Mouse Mansion on her desk and later showed it to the writing class that came in after school. That night, Sam found the note and it read, Dear Sam, all of us at the library have been enjoying your books immensely. It's a new word, immensely. We are all wondering who this mysterious Sam really is. Whoever you are, you certainly have a lot of talent. Not everyone has it in them to write even a single book, let alone three. We think it would be fun to have a Meet the Author Day with you as our special guest. The children would love to hear you read your books and share some of your secrets for writing. Yours truly, Mrs. Forrester, head librarian. Wow. That's amazing.
The attention of the head librarian.
It is. I had a student one time who wrote a book. She and her mama co-authored a book. She was only in middle school too.
Sam felt very nervous. He was happy that the children at the library liked his books. He was flattered that they wanted to meet him. But mice, as a rule, are very shy when it comes to meeting people. Sam could not understand why people thought that writing and making up stories was so hard. If only they would try, they might find out that writing was really lots of fun. Sam had an idea. He went to the librarian's desk and got some supplies. All night long, he wrote and drew and snipped and folded and stapled his little rectangulars of paper into mouse-sized books. Wow.
So, you know, we talked about a night on Bald Mountain. I want us to, maybe we could have had a night on Bald Mountain playing while this was being read. So, I'm giving you homework, Dr. Laws.
Yes.
Night on Bald Mountain by Modest Mussorgsky. Meet the author. In the morning, when the librarian opened up the children's room, there was a sheet of paper taped to the door. Meet the author today, it read. A little girl was the first to see Sam's display all set up on the front table. What is this? She asked. There sat a tissue box with a pair of pencils taped to the sides of and a banner stretched across the top. On the banner was written, Meet the Author, with an arrow pointing down. They're all just wondering, who is this and what is this? And then there's the author, and this is really cute. Who is the author?
One exciting thing of reading it gives you anticipation.
Absolutely.
The girl bent over to look in the empty tissue box. Oh, she said in surprise. But there at the bottom of the box lay Sam's little mirror. And in the mirror, the little girl saw her own face smiling up at her. Me, she said, an author? Next to the mirror was a stack of tiny blank books and a pile of pencils that Sam had sharpened with his little teeth.
Sam's nice. All that day, and for many more thereafter, people came to the little display to meet the author. Soon there was a whole shelf full of books written and illustrated by people who had never written a book before, telling stories that had never been told. Seems like Sam sparked some creativity. They are doing things they never thought they'd do. Wow, when I grow up, The Perfect Pet, Zip Zoom, ABC in the Library, The Adventures of Me, The Smartest Dog. It's just the name of a few of the books that they had written.
Sam was a library mouse. His home was in a little hole in the wall behind the children's reference books. All that night, Sam sat in his hole, thinking and thinking about the next book he would write. Would it be a mystery, an adventure, a funny book, a true story? There were so many stories to tell. Aha, he thought. I'll just have to write one of each. Sam picked up his pencil and got to work. That's what it takes, a lot of time just to pick up the pencil.
So, Dr. Laws, now that we've come to the end of our book, what do you think the message is to our viewers?
I think I took several things from Sam. First, at the end was a very good summation. Pick up the pencil and write about things we know, mm-hmm. things we experience, mm-hmm. things we're excited about. And you'll be surprised how much people appreciate your stories.
Mm-hmm. I would agree. And I think many of us have a lot to write about, our self-reflection and our lived experiences. You'd be amazed at how many people would be intrigued by your experiences. And so I think that Sam tapped into, and I said this a few moments ago, tapped into the creativity of the little people that he was hiding from in the library. And allowing them to understand the reflection of the author is you. So I would encourage our children at this time. I'm going to encourage them to tap into their talent and to begin writing, drawing, and really envisioning how you see yourself and your experiences and put it into writing, like in a diary or in a tablet. And I guarantee you, some of them will become New York's finest bestsellers on that list. And I'll be the first to read, since I read a lot. And so don't forget, David, Dr. Laws, you have an assignment. And so I'm going to encourage you to tap into your musical side. And after you listen to Modest Mussorgsky's A Night on Bald Mountain, you'll see the I'm not going to tell you.
I'm going to find out.
You're going to find out. And so just report back to me, and then that will be your lived experience, and then I'm going to challenge you to write about it. So as our children are writing or drawing, listen to music because it inspires you as well. Dr. Laws, can I just say this to you? Thank you. Thank you for sharing The Library Mouse and the book about Sam to our young audience. And I appreciate you for all that you do for our students here in Sumter School District. Keep doing what you're doing. And thank you again for joining us. And thank you to our viewers for watching.
Thank you
for joining us for another evening of Superintendent, Reading with the Superintendent. And have a great evening.